So you are able to see the screen, right?
Yes, sir.
So we'll start our. So if you remember, so last class we have started our plates. Okay, it is essentially buckling of plates you are looking into in great detail. One second. So this buckling, we started in our last class. Okay. So this buckling of plates. Okay. So this we have already started. So I think last class, or the last week. Okay. So we have derived all the equations of motion. Or equilibrium essentially. Okay, so these equations of equilibrium, we have derived in our last class by both the methods, from calculus of variations as well as from the ordinary you followed, right? The free body diagram you draw, and then sigma fx, moment equilibrium, force equilibrium we have used, and we have derived our equations also. Okay, I think last class we have also derived this the expression for buckling. Okay, for a simply supported plate. So, and simply supported on all the edges, okay. And I think one more important thing what we have seen in our last class is how to represent the boundary conditions, okay. So, as already I told you, the boundary conditions, when you are writing for plates, you have to be little bit careful actually, okay. So, fixed plate or, if it is a simply supported, if it is something else. So, this also we have discussed in detail in the last class. You can refer our last class video, okay. So, all the details has been provided to you, okay. So, now when there is a plate and beam or interface is there, so how do we represent, okay. Deflection continuous, then this one, and how to the load also, okay, how to transfer it on the beam, then the movements and other things also we have discussed, okay, in the last class. So now when it comes to this buckling, say, okay, I think we already derived for the simply supported beam. I think the design is something like this, if you remember, so is it, so nx, so that is the buckling load. So this is the problem which we have derived, okay. So simply supported, so you have this nx, which is like a udl kind of a thing, okay. So now nx was something, is it, so k d pi square by b square kind of a thing. And then what we observed was this is like a constant, say, okay. So this depends on the aspect ratio, that is a by b ratio here itself. And we have also seen that there is, for plates, say, okay, essentially this type of a plate, when a by b, okay, if it is less than root 2, so it buckles in the first mode. But whereas if it is more than root 2, say, okay, so you can have a second mode kind of a failure also, okay. So it depends on your aspect ratio. So in plate also, it's not like the first mode is the only one which gives you the lowest kind of a load, but higher modes are also possible. So the controlling factor is the a by b, okay. So depending, if so a by b, if it is more, say, then there is a chance of getting the plate getting buckled into the higher modes, this one. And as already I suggested you, to visualize this one, you can write a small program in MATLAB, okay. So you can try, and then you increase a by b, say you have to plot the mode shapes, okay. So you can plot mode shapes, how this plate is going to buckle. So I already, the mode shape, what is the mode shape for simply supported plate on all the edges? So like last class we said, right, what is the mode shape here?
Sinusoidal, sir.
Sinusoidal. So if you want to plot it in MATLAB, say, so this is our that, so AMN. Anyway, coefficient is not important for us. We are interested only in the mode shape, m pi x by a, then sine n pi y by b, okay. So you take a plate, say, this anyway you can ignore. So this is our mode shape. So what you can do is, so you take some a by b, you followed, right, less than root 2, say. You plot this function, okay. Then m is equal to, you followed, right, you know the buckling mode shape. And if a by b is more than this one, say, you take, and then you can plot the mode shapes of the plate, okay. So, and you can use the surf command, you followed it, or mesh command in MATLAB. You can plot, say, you yourself can visualize, that half sine wave, two sine waves, all those things. So I suggest all of anyway, the assignment also we will give you. So write a small program set to visualize, you know, these mode shapes, okay, how they look like. As I told you, right, there is a chance of getting, you know, half sine wave, okay, m is equal to 1, n is equal to n, the buckling shape will be, you know, something like this. Suppose if m is equal to 2, n is equal to 1, say, so already, so then, you know, the buckling mode shape you followed, right? This side will be half sine wave, but here you will see, you see, like this type of a thing, so, okay, in one direction, you know, say, you know, so you in MATLAB, you know, then your understanding will be much better actually. Okay, so for this, of course, this solution is valid only for the plate simply supported and all the edges. Okay, so be careful. Suppose if the boundary condition is different, so then you know, you will have other kind of problems. Okay, so now let us see the same problem, say, so the same simply supported plate with other boundary conditions, what happens. Okay, so in plates it is very difficult, you know, to get closed form solutions, so because, you know, PD, all kinds of things are there. Okay, so now let us say this is a plate. Okay, so this is A and this is B. This is A and this is B. These are the dimensions of the plate, and NX anyway you are having, you know, this compressive force. And let us say we say that the plate is simply supported, say, so, you know, so it is simply supported on x is equal to A, 0, and x is equal to A. Okay, so this is simply supported. Now in y direction, say, at y is equal to 0 and y is equal to B. Okay, so the boundary conditions are, you know, they are not simply supported. They may be anything else. Okay, so they may be fixed, or they may be free, or maybe, you know, in practical purposes, if you want to say, so these two edges may be connected to some beams itself, okay, or maybe some you followed it, variety of boundary conditions can happen. So now how do you solve these type of problems? Okay, so our anyway the equation we have, so due to the power of four, the fourth order, you know, the PD, which we solved in the last class itself. So this is our equation. So dou x square and dou y square plus dou to the power of 4 w, say, dou y, pardon, this one, and you have this nx will be there, ny, because ny is 0, nxy is also 0, all those terms goes to 0, so you have only nx will be there, so you can write, you know, so dou square w by dou x square. So this is our equation of equilibrium, which we solved in our last class also for simply supported. Now the same equation, now we have solve. So in x direction it is simply supported, in y direction, you know, you don't know, you followed, right, the boundary conditions may vary. Now how do you solve these type of equations? So now getting, as already I told you, right, in closed form solutions are very difficult, okay, for fourth order ODEs, you know, it becomes very problematic. So now how do you write the solution for this? In the last class, how did we solve the problem when all the edges were simply supported? No. See, the previous class, how did we solve these equations of equilibrium? You know, you remember?
So we solved the
solution. Okay. So we assume. So we didn't solve the, you know, we did not solve the PDE at all. What we have done is, you know, based on our intuitiveness or whatever, you know, we already know simply supported means we already have our problem. Exact solution we have not got. Okay. But of course, sine and anyway, you know, that works fine. So your solution may be considered as exact itself. So now in this problem also, now what is the mode shape you have to assume, or how you are going to proceed now, this type of a problem? Now, so in one direction, it is simply supported. Other direction, you don't know. Okay, so now how do you solve this type of a problems? Now, you cannot solve the PDE. Okay, so now how to solve this by some approximations, or you know, how do you assume the mode shape now? So what is the mode shape now?
So in one direction it will be sinusoidal.
No, one direction it is sinusoidal. In y direction you don't know, you followed, right? It depends on the boundary condition. So how do you write this expression? You know, it is same as, you know, you would have done in other courses. So we don't know f of y, okay, but other direction it is sinusoidal. Okay, so this is how, you see, we can write the solutions. And of course you can prove that, you know, so at x is equal to the boundary conditions, say, okay, So at x is equal to 0, and of course at x is equal to a, bending moment is 0 and deflection is 0. Okay, so bending moment expression also, you know, mx, my, be careful. Already the same notations we have to follow. So mu or dou square w by, you see, dou y square, say. So this is 0. Movement and bending are 0 for this type of a problem. Okay, the last class, what did we do? See, this one, what did we do? You remember, although your bending moment consists of you know, x as well as y, but because all four edges are simply supported, because w will be 0 in other direction, so this anyway term goes away. So automatically you can write as simply dou square w by dou x square is equal to 0 itself, like that we did. But now this problem you can't do, because you don't know the boundary condition, what type of condition you are having at the edges, at the y's. Okay, so we will keep it you know, like this itself. So now, you know, so you substitute, say, whatever w, okay, so in our equations of equilibrium, okay, so you will get, you know, so this PDE is converted into a ordinary differential equation. So here, so this, so here what we are trying to do, in x direction, since you have assumed, say, so PDE is gone, so now you have only ODE. ODEs are little bit easy to solve, okay. So dy to the power of 4 minus, you know, so 2m square pi square by using a square. So some d square f, say, okay. So by dy square, and of course you have, you know, other term, okay, which contains nx and other things will be there. Pi to the power of 4 by using a to the power of 4 minus nx by d, say, okay. So m square pi square by a square. Okay, multiplied by f is equal to 0. So this is our equation of equilibrium. So PDE has become an ordinary differential equation. So now how do you solve this ordinary differential equation? It is just a fourth order equation. Okay, so it is same as what we did for columns also long back, you know. Column equation also you can write in terms of fourth order ODE. Q is equal to EI, you know, that d to the power of 4, you remember, y by dx to the power of 4. It's just a fourth order ODE only, okay? And these are the coefficients, okay? So now all the coefficients, they are not, you know, they are like a constant kind of a thing. They are not varying coefficients. Suppose if you are having varying coefficients, say, then you remember, right? And that gives another headache. So when you are having ODEs with varying coefficients, then you remember that self-buckling problem we have solved, you know, or other problems also. So then your Bessel functions, you know, they come into our calculations. Suppose if you are having a ODE with constant coefficients, say, then it is very easy to solve. You know, you can write as e to the power of lambda y, and then, you know, you can calculate all the roots, eats, and other things also. Okay. So now if you define some two new variables, alpha, you know, some m square pi square by a square, so it is very straight easy to solve this ODE. Okay, some nx by d m square pi square by, you see, a square, so this is some roots kind of a thing, you can say, okay. And beta, say, this is also another root which comes from this equations, minus m square pi square by a square plus, so nx by d we have, then m square pi square by a square. Okay, so these are, you can say, you can easily solve yourself. Okay, you substitute e to the power of lambda y, and then you find out the four roots will be there, you know, because it's a fourth order ODE, you will get lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3, lambda 4, and you can substitute also. So finally the solution, say, okay, so you can write you know, like this. So f of y, as, you know, e to the power of minus alpha y plus c2 e to the power of you know, alpha y. So four roots will be there. The roots will be minus alpha plus alpha, then minus beta plus beta, kind of a thing. Okay, and some imaginary things will come. So finally, say, so this turns out to be, you know, some cos beta y plus so c4 is sine beta y. Okay, so here also you can write, actually, so the same problem, say, you can write generally, you know, the solution also in terms of hyperbolic functions also you can write. Okay, so there is you know, nothing wrong. So it depends, actually, how you are writing the solution. So some textbooks, if you see what they do is you know, you remember, so when you are having these type of terms, you say, so this will come from the imaginary, this one, So some textbooks, if you see, they write these expressions in terms of cos, you know, the hyperbolic also. Some you followed, right? C2, you see, sine, you know, the hyperbolic you followed, right? Alpha times y, plus, of course, C3 cos beta y. So these terms are going to remain same itself, okay? So whichever way you write, anyway you followed, right? You can write in terms of hyperbolic, or you can leave it as it is, and depending on the boundary conditions, say, whichever is easy, you know, you can solve the problem. Okay. So now let us see some cases. Okay. So now we are saying x is equal to 0 and x is equal to a is simply supported. Okay. So now we will use you know, some other complicated boundary conditions, say. So now we say that y is equal to 0 is also simply supported. So three edges are simply supported. Okay. So this is simply supported, and but y is equal to b, say, it is a free edge. You followed. So now it is a free edge. So now you see, so now we have to write the boundary condition. So when it is simply supported, say, it is very easy. So because w 0, then dou square w by dou y square plus nu dou square w, say, by dou x square is equal to 0 for y is equal to 0. Okay. And now when it is a free end, say, what is the boundary condition? You remember last class, you know, I told you how to write the boundary condition for free edge. Now, what is that Kirchhoff boundary condition? See, general, as I told you, in plate, at any edge, say, you have, you know, bending moment is there, shear force is there, then you have twisting moments also. Three things are there, okay, at the edges. Now, how do you write?
Shear force and twisting.
Twisting, they are combined, okay? So, instead of having three, say, we write only in terms of two, okay? Please, you know, remember that one. That's very important. That is, anyway, of course, as you told, you know, Gaurav told, it is what we call as, you know, the Kirchhoff boundary conditions, okay? So, we write bending moment is zero. So, that means dou square double this expression. So, nu dou square w, say, by dou x square. So, bending moment is zero. Okay, now shear force and twisting moment, you see, we combine into one equation. This is a very, very important boundary condition in plates. So this all of you have to remember. Otherwise, you know, you will be left with, you know, three boundary conditions. One for shear force, one for twisting, another for bending. That doesn't happen. Okay, so 2 minus nu. So this combination, say, so this comes to this type of a boundary condition. Dou y is equal to 0 at y is equal to b. So this is a special boundary condition. You can also write it is a, like a combination of, you know, your shear force, say, and a twisting moment. Okay, so this is a very, very important thing in plates to write the boundary conditions. Okay, so now you followed, right? So now we have four constants are there, I think C1, C2, C3, C4, and then four boundary conditions we have. Okay, so 1, then 2, then 3, then 4. So now we have to do some algebra actually. Okay, so substituting and trying to find out and other things, but it is very easy. You can find out that C1 will be, you know, some minus C2. And of course, C3 will be 0. So you will get, you followed, right? So from these boundary conditions, you say, so you will get, you know, C1 is minus C2 and C3 is 0. So which comes from, you know, this, from this two con, this one, that is, you know, but y is equal to this expression, okay? And now you have two more equations are there. So finally, you can write our Fy, say, as some a sine you know, hyperbolic alpha times y plus b sine you know, beta times you know, the y. So these are your f. Okay, so now, so you know the final, so now you write for the entire you know, the deflection. So w, anyway, you followed, right? So this a sine hyperbolic alpha times y plus b sine, say, beta y multiplied by, you know, we had this sine m pi x by a. Okay, so now while, so substitute this in our these two boundary conditions. Okay, that is, we are the this end and the free end. So this equations you do, so two constants are there, a and b. So you will have two equations. So as usual, you know, you take A and B outside, then the determinant of the matrix, you know, has to be equal to 0. So you just substitute okay, in those buffery boundary conditions. So you will have two equations, and then you know, you write in terms of a, you know, this type of a matrix, you know. So A, B, you follow, right, is equal to 0, 0 kind of a thing. So for non-trivial solutions, say, so determinant of this matrix here has to be 0. So if you write for directly all those, you know, the equations, say, okay. So you can write these expressions as, you know, like this. So two equations comes, and finally, you know, the determinant of the expression, say, it will be like this. So beta into alpha square minus mu m square pi square by a square whole square. So tan, you know, the hyperbolic, some, you know, alpha times b, that is nothing but the aspect ratio, that is another length of the plate. So this is alpha into, say, beta square plus mu m square pi square by a square, okay, so whole square, and tan beta times b, okay. So this is our transcendental equation, which you have to solve to find out our buckling load, okay. So now here, where is the buckling load, where is that nx coming into picture here, which terms contain nx? So you remember, so this alpha, beta, which are the roots of our equations, say. So alpha contains, you know, your nx, okay. Even our beta also contains, you see, nx. So if you substitute alpha, beta in that expression, say, so finally you have the only unknown in that expression is, you know, this nx, okay. So this nx has to be estimated by solving the transcendental equation, and of course it has many roots are there, so you have to find out the lowest root, you know, whatever is possible. So here also you cannot have any closed form solution, you know, like for example nx is, you know, like we had for the columns, say, fixed and free and whatever we had a closed form 20.2 or, you know, some pi square ei. So that the luxury we had, but in plates, you know, the things becomes a little bit complex. So you may have to solve this on a numerically, on a computer kind of a thing, okay. But of course, you know, so one can write this nx critical load, say, okay, everything in terms of some k pi square d by using b square kind of a thing. So our, you know, the nx critical buckling load will be like this, and this k is a constant, okay. So as already I told you, so you have to give, you have to do it numerically, okay. So numerically you have to estimate, and this k also, in this case also, it depends on a by b. So generally, like you see in the design charts, say, like, you know, people give in terms of you followed it, like k, you know, so this a by b versus you know, the k kind of, so a by b is 0.5, say, so k is some 4.4. Like that, we have some, you know, the several types of numbers. So 1.44, suppose if it is 1.2, so 1.135. So like that, you know, we will get these type of charts here. But here there is, you know, one issue is there. Okay, the what is the most important thing here? See, when you solve these expressions, see, the it also, of course, nx is there, but it also depends on m also. So you have to be very, very careful. Okay. So for m is equal to 1, you get these sets of k, say, and m is equal to 2, you can get these sets of k. So now in plates, the most important, what may happen? Say, like previously also we have seen. What is the main thing here? See, what is the most important thing in the plate buckling? Okay. Say, like last class also we have seen, right?
Mode of buckling will depend on the aspect ratio.
Aspect ratio. So now this solution. So now here what you have to do, you assume m is equal to 1. So, and then you solve this equation, say, okay. So you will get a set of, you know, the k values, and you know a by b, you can get this one. Now what you have to do in this problem? So you have to plot for m is equal to 2 also, you have to calculate. Suppose if the aspect ratio, if it is a lower side, say, then in any way you followed, right, it will buckle in the first mode only. But, you know, you have to calculate for all possible combinations, and then only you follow it, you have to come to a conclusion, okay. So this is a very, very, you know, the important thing, you know, when we follow it for calculating, you see, the buckling loads, okay. So like this, so there is no closed form solution, so you have to do only by this type of, you know, numerically, you have to implement in a computer, you can get these constants, okay. So this is the most important thing in the plates. So no more, you know, the closed form. See now let us say one edge is a, so y is equal to 0 is built-in edge, or you know, the fixed kind of a thing. Okay, this word also people use, you know, built-in, it is a fixed edge. And y is equal to b say is a free edge. Okay, now same problem say, so now previous case it was y is equal to 0 was simply supported, other edge was free. So now you are having you know, a plate which is simply supported, a simply supported, simply supported, one end is fixed, sorry, this is fixed, and this is you know, free kind of a case. So now how the solutions value? So anyway, you know the boundary conditions you followed, right? You know how to write. So the boundary conditions are going to be different. So when for fixed end say, what happens for a fixed end? No. Deflection zero. No.
Slope.
Slope, and here slope is very easy. Okay, it is same as your you know, whatever you did for your beam itself. Okay, at y is equal to zero. Then for free end say, just now we have written the boundary conditions. Same boundary conditions becomes valid. Plus nu dou square w by dou x square is equal to 0. Then we have dou square w, so that is a combination of shear force and I think dou cube, sorry, plus 2 minus nu, so dou cube w by dou x square dou y, so this is equal to 0. So combination of shear force and twisting moments, okay, so this is valid at y is equal to b. So similar way say, you have to calculate all those f of y, the c1 c2 c3 constants, and finally you know, you can write. So you could do the boundary conditions, so c1 turns out to be minus alpha c3 minus beta c4 divided by c 2 times alpha, then c2 this also minus, sorry, this becomes like this. Oh, sorry, this one. So this turns out to be minus alpha times C3 plus beta times C4 by AC 2 times alpha. So you substitute and then you know, you solve. So you will get, you followed, right? A big, you know, the equation. So determinant, you know, you will get a determinant, and this is much more complicated actually. Okay. So you followed it. So everything you write in terms of C3, C4. So you will get a matrix like this, you know, is equal to 0, 0. You find out the determinant. So now this is much more complex. So the equation turns out to be 2TS S square plus T square. So cos of beta times B, then cos hyperbolic say alpha times B. So on right hand side, it will be 1 by alpha times beta. 1 by alpha times beta, so alpha square t square minus beta square some s square, so sine beta times b, then sine hyperbolic say alpha times b. Okay, very complex equation, and t is nothing but some beta square plus nu m square pi square by a square, and s. So this is also another constant, alpha square minus mu m square pi square say by some a square. Okay, you can see the complexity follow, right? It increases actually. So now this also, so where is, you have to solve for nx. So nx, ny are in beta and alpha. So wherever the beta is there, say, so alpha, they contain you know, the nx. So nx is in you followed it, alpha and beta. So you have to substitute that one, and you have to solve for you know, the nx here. So here also you have the same problem. So you know, here also of course you can represent in terms of that same formula kind of you know, like for example nx critical load say, so k pi square b by you followed right, b square. So you can write in terms of this one, and you can solve, like you see, for various aspect ratios, you know, so like you can have a design chart kind of a thing. So if a by b is, I will just write for one, so you can write for other cases. So this becomes, you know, 1.7, then you followed right, so for 1.3 say 1.47, like this, you know, you can write for variety of the values. And for this problem, as already I told you, you have to be very careful, okay? So because there is a chance of getting, so same thing you have to repeat. You assume m is equal to 1, you calculate all cases, eh? Then you assume m is equal to 2, and you can calculate, you see, all the cases. So now this problem, you know, approximately at so 2 by 3 to when a by b you followed is at around 2.3 or something like that, okay, 2.3 to 2.4. What happens is your m is equal to 2, say, will be lower than m is equal to 1, the buckling loads. So if you try to calculate so this is like a point actually. So like for simply supported, what was the this junction? See, for simply supported junction was root 2, okay, 1.414, okay. So now when it is fixed, then free, then 2 simply supported, then this that junction, some 2.2 like that, it comes. So you can calculate on a MATLAB, it's very easy. So MATLAB has, you can find out the solutions for a transcendental equation. So what you have to do, you have to just substitute this determinant, and you assume m is equal to 1, and then you ask MATLAB to give you the roots, say. So automatically they will give you, you followed, right, the roots itself. So you can easily calculate and find out these numbers. So generally, these type of numbers, they use it in design charts. See, like for example, who uses plates regularly, plates in which like you remember this iron plates you followed, right? They use these type of things, where? Mostly you followed, right? Ocean structures are there, you understand? Like a ship, you followed, no? Ships. They all have, more or less it's like a plate kind of a thing. Everywhere, the plates will be there. So these type of structures, they use this type of design charts will be there. If it is a variety of boundary conditions, what happens? So they will give you, these type of cases itself, okay? So you can, so this is how, we can find out, you see, the buckling for variety of boundary conditions. So this way, you can do, several cases. Like for example, you can derive yourself. So both the sides, say, are fixed, okay? Y is equal to 0 and y is equal to b. Both of them are fixed. Then what happens? You follow it. Now, similarly, say, so now, suppose if it is supported on the beams, so you, I will give it as an assignment to you on both the sides. So now when there is a beam, say, what is the boundary condition? Last class, you remember. So we have written the boundary condition also. So at the junction of the beam, so you followed, right? The force also has to be, deflection anyway, slope will be continuous. Your cracks and other things problem comes because of compatibility. Then apart from that, you can, right, how to calculate the load, which comes on the beam. What is that expression? Anybody remember? No. How did we calculate? You remember? The load which comes on the beam actually. So if you know the shear force, then the twisting moment, say, you remember? So this we equated actually, the shear force, the load or whatever. So this you have to equate it to, this EI, dou to the power of 4 by dou y to the power of 4, okay? This is a load which comes on the beam, okay? Which is a combination of shear force and twisting moment here. So now, so this you have, so you know qx minus dou mx, you know all these expressions. So that is nothing but same as this one only, okay? So just now we wrote the boundary condition, right? So this expression. So 2 minus nu, so this you have to write on the right hand side, it will be EI, okay? So dou to the power of 4 W by using dou y to the power of 4, okay? It is not equal to 0. So you equate this expression, you will get this one. Now movements, what you have to do? You remember, so bending moment you have to write as? See, now when it is a built up, when there is a beam there, say, now what will be the bending moment? Shear force anyway, this is a junction, okay? Between the beam and the this plate. So now the bending moment, say, so now last class we already wrote that expression. So bending moment, see, bending in the plate is related to twist, that torsion which comes on the beam. So last class I think we have written, so like some minus c into some dou by dou y, dou cube right, double dot dou square w by say, dou x dou y. So this is equal to your bending moment in the plate. Okay. So nu dou square w by u dou y square. So this is a bending moment. So this is a torsional rigidity. Okay, of the beam. So you can solve actually. Okay, by variety of boundary conditions. how the values looks like, how in what way, they differ, and you can try for, the variety of the problems. Okay, so I leave it to you. Maybe in the assignment, you can use these things. Of course, this problem is much more complex. Okay, because the determinant equation itself, it will be very highly complex. The transcendental equations. Okay, so but results will be very interesting if you try to plot it in on a computer, okay, which how it is going to buckle and or suppose if at these two beams are highly rigid, then it has to fixed that solution it should go. You can try a variety of this ways itself, okay. So now anyway, so this is how we try to solve many problems in plates by this directly assuming some mode shape and based on and getting this closed form solutions. So now let us see, you can solve the same problems, say, okay, by energy methods also, which are approximate methods. Okay, let us just see this energy method also. All of already, right, the energy methods, I think last class when we derived our equations of equilibrium, so by calculus of variations, we already wrote all the things. So we already derived, but the most important thing what we noticed was your U, okay. So this is strain energy. So generally in the plate, how many strain energies are there? Of course, work done by the load, that is a different issue. You remember last class when we wrote our calculus of variations. Say when we wrote the strain energy, I told you two terms are there actually. Combination of two. What are those? So membrane and bending strain energy. You remember. So membrane comes from that U, V. You remember the higher order terms are there in the strains. Okay. So we wrote, I think epsilon xx was dou U by dou x plus we had this half, like this also higher order terms, and then these are, so you can separate these two into two things. So if you take linear strain or something, right, if you ignore these things, so then you will have bending strain energy will be there. So you can include both of them, you can solve, but generally you followed it. So this term will be, you can calculate in a problem, say. So this will be very small actually, in most of the problems. So in the linear strain, and if you do all those things, so then anyway, this thing gets vanished. So you will have only this bending strain energy only, okay. I hope you remember the expression also. I think last class we already wrote it, the bending strain energy. We wrote expressions for both, okay. So I think if you remember, so this expression was some d by 2, 0 to b, then 0 to a. So all will be in terms of w only, okay. So dou square w by dou x square whole square plus dou square w say by dou y square whole square plus 2 times mu, mu and Poisson's ratio, okay. So 2 mu or dou square w by dou x square, dou square w say by dou y square, okay, plus 2 into 1 minus mu, that's anything with the Poisson's ratio. So dou square w say by dou x dou y whole square, okay. So this entire expression dx times dy. So this is our bending strain energy. The membrane strain energy also we have written. So that expression, I hope, where is that expression? So we have already written that membrane strain energy. So this I hope you remember, right? So this was the bending strain energy, and the membrane strain energy was written in some C by 2 epsilon x square plus epsilon the y square plus 2 mu epsilon x epsilon y minus 1 minus mu by 2 gamma square xy dx dy, okay. So this is our bending strain energy, and of course epsilon x is nothing but so your dou u by you followed, right? So that dou x and other terms comes into picture, okay. So I hope this you followed, right? You remember this expression. So epsilon x, you remember, right? Like previously we have written, is dou u by dou x plus half into x whole square. Then we also had this curvature, you know, one more constants was there, okay, and epsilon dash x, I think, I hope all of you remember. So this was our you know, the bending strain energy, the membrane strain energy, okay. So generally in most of the calculations, you know, generally in plates, when things are very small, so this term you can calculate yourself and you can check how much is um significant with respect to B. But sometimes, so this term will be, you followed it, very very low compared to this bending strain energy. So sometimes we neglect this term, okay. But there may be some cases where you cannot neglect this um, but many times in bending we neglect this um, okay. So now you know the strain energy. So now you can use this energy methods also, you know, it's an easy way to calculate for plates. So let us say you have a plate like this, okay. So same this type of thing. So this is x and this is y, say a, and then b is here, okay. And so now you know, or if you want, for the time being, so if you take as a square plate, okay, so both the sides are same. So now let us say it is fixed along all the edges. You can take simply supported also, fixed on all the edges, okay. So now you want to find out the buckling load actually for this square plate. Now how do you solve by energy method? Like previously you remember, how do you solve energy methods? Now what is that you try to do? In the energy method, what is that you try to do? You remember, like previously we have solved many problems. Now what is that you do in energy method, right?
So we assume the mode shape.
So now you have to assume the mode shape, okay. So now for this, what is the mode shape? Of course, sinus, simply supported means it is very easy. Sin m pi x, sin sinusoids you can write, but now all the edges are fixed actually, okay. So you can go back to your columns and see what type of modes are there. So generally for this, the mode shape can be written as, because it is fixed, say, so 2 pi x by a, and then you know, 1 minus cos you know, 2 pi y by a. So this is our mode shape. You can verify it satisfies all the boundary conditions. So what are the boundary conditions on all four the sides? It's a fixed, say, so dou w by dou y, this is 0 at one end, other end also w is equal to 0, so dou w by dou x. Actually you can verify it satisfies all the boundary conditions, okay. So you, this is our assumed mode shape. So this
sir,
depends
there one minus, sir, there 1 minus cos 2 pi y by b, sir,
y by b, but now what is that we are assuming here?
Square. Okay,
so if it is not, you put b itself, there is nothing wrong, okay. If you put a and b are separate, so what problem you have, you know, the equations becomes you know, more complex. That is the only reason, okay, for a square plate. If you want, you can try. So now what is that you have to do? Now once you have calculated, once you have assumed mode shapes, say, next step is you have to calculate energies, okay. So one is strain energy, other one is the potential energy, that is the work done by the load itself, okay. So you calculate your potential energy, strain energy, so only the bending strain energy only, okay. So we are not doing, so here you know, you have to do a lot of you understand the derivations, you know, this different derivative has to be found out, square, and so many algebraic things are you know there here. And then after you do this also, you have to calculate this integrals also, 0 to a, 0 to b, and dx you know, dy, okay. So you followed it, so this has to be, you know, so this is a very tedious process. But you know, right, in MATLAB, and I hope all of you know MAPL software or MATLAB, they have a symbolic toolbox is there. You remember, right, all of you? Are you aware of symbolic toolboxes in MATLAB? Okay. You know, or it is in MATLAB, or suppose if you have this MAPL software, or even Mathematica also, okay. So you can solve these things in closed form itself. So in MATLAB, you know, you can define symbolic variables, say. this command sim or right, x y, so they will treat as a symbolic this one, and you can evaluate all those integrals. Okay, MATLAB, if you do the dou square w by dou x square and w, you give this expression and you integrate, you know, you will get a closed form itself. Okay, so you people can try. Okay, so this bending strain energy, say, so we will not write those big expressions. Okay, so this will be something like this, very simple. So 8d pi to the power of 4 a square by, you see, some a to the power of 4. Yeah, so this will be, you know, a by 2 into, you see, a plus a by 2, very simple. Okay, so plus, after you do all the calculations, you know, it looks something like this, evaluation of integrals also. Okay, so plus 2 mu a square by 4 plus 2 into 1 minus mu, that is the Poisson's ratio, a square by 4. Okay, so these, after you evaluate the substitute w, do the calculations, and then you integrate also. So after you do all those things, you know, so you will get a nice this one as 16 d pi to the power of 4 a square by, you know, a square. So this is our bending strain energy. Actually, you can see, that is the power of energy methods, you know, very simple things you will get. And now you have to find out potential energy, that is the work done by the loads. Okay, last class, you know, we have written, when we did the calculus of variations, say, what is the work done by NX, you remember, you know, one was work done by the, see, suppose if you're having a plate here, say, you can have this type of load, transverse loads. So then the work done will be simply P times, if it is a P, say, W, you write, and of course you have to integrate, you know, dx, dy, and like that we write. Now you are having this expression, you remember. Now how do you calculate the work done by this this load, that is a compression? How did we write in the last class? Any remember? How did we write the, you know, work done by this type of loads, NX? What is that you have to do? No, see, now how do you calculate this work done by NX? No. See, there are two ways are there. One is you go through the plate theory, or other easy ways, suppose you take a small strip, say, you assume it as a column. Now you remember, for a column, how did we calculate the, you know, this work done? You know, work done by the load. You remember, right? So we had a column here. So what did we say? The column has reduced the length, actually. So this we used to write it as delta. You remember? So how do we used to calculate this delta? You remember? So ds minus l we wrote. And finally, if you see the expressions, the shortening of the column due to bending, you have a second derivative will be there. You remember? You know, you can, you followed, right? That also you can use. So work done by the loads there. Is, you know, so if you take a small this one, nx into dy, okay, and you can take it as a column. So for a column, say, so this one will be 0 to a, so you have dou w by dou x, okay, so whole square into dx, so you will have a second derivative. You can just check your columns itself, or other way to calculate, say, so like last class, what is the work done by the, you know, how did we calculate, you remember, by this load? I didn't enter the calculations, but you know, how did we write? So how did we, you remember how to write that one? So what did we do in the last class? We wrote the px is the load, say. How did we write? U at a minus u at, you remember, no? We wrote like this. And what is that we wrote finally? We wrote as you know, px by b we wrote. And finally, this u minus a, so this is anyway nothing but a derivative kind of a thing. So 0 to a we wrote. So dou u by dou x dx dy. You remember, no? This is how we calculated actually. And one can show that if you neglect all the, you know, that epsilon dash x, say, okay. So one can show that like this. So if you neglect this epsilon dash x, you know, you can write the work done in this format. So this epsilon dash x, okay, so this you know, so what is this epsilon or epsilon x, say, let me just, so this is dou u by dou x plus half you know, dou w by dou x, you see, the whole square here. So we can write this expression, say, so dou u by dou x. So if you ignore this, this term epsilon, is because you are neglecting this membrane, at the centroidal axis. So you can replace this with, so dou u by dou x, okay, is minus of half, so dou w by dou x, you see, the whole square. Okay, so we can write, in this format. So if you substitute this in this expression, say, what happens? So you will get once again the same equation, whatever we like, from the columns, say, you will get more or less, you see, the same expressions. Okay, so this is one way to write from the plate, or this one. Suppose if you are having ny, say, now what will be the work done by ny? So if you have ny, now we are writing for x. Now suppose if it is ny, say, now what is that work done by ny? What happens? Which term will get changed here? What you have to change now? If it is ny,
ny into dx it will be.
Ny into dx, but what happens to this term, this derivative?
Dou w by dou y.
Dou w by dou y actually. Now suppose nxy shear. Shear, what happens?
It will be nxy here.
So it is very easy. See, what is, you remember, right? Gamma xy. So dou u by dou y plus dou v by dou x plus we have dou w by dou x, okay, dou w by dou y, okay. Now we are neglecting this term. So now what happens? So dou v by dou u by dou y plus dou v by dou x is, you can write everything in terms of displacements only, this vertical displacement only. And now what is the work done by nxy? Nxy is a in plane shear. So nxy will be like in plane shear itself. So you can substitute actually. Okay. So this will be dou u by dou y plus dou v by dou x. So it is nothing but, your nxy epsilon xy, like that we write. So now we, since we are neglecting those things, so now your dou u by dou y, so this you have to replace with this itself. So now your work done by the load will be simply nxy multiplied by dou w by dou x, dou w by dou y. So this is how, we write for a, and of course you have to do this integration will be there. Okay, so this is how, we try to find out, the work done by your the in plane forces itself. Okay, so anyway, I think time is up, so I will stop here. So we will continue in our next class. Okay, but of course I will be sending you this assignment, but I suggest all of you, what you can do is you can go to MATLAB, say, okay. So you can start writing some small programs, for good visualization. Okay, otherwise, these expressions, you will not get any physical meaning itself, feeling of this one.